I think that art is a very good way to just express yourself. Well, we made the mosaics to tell other people what's going on in Afghanistan. And mine pretty much just says, even though there's so much chaos going on in Afghanistan, that's all these tiles. There's good things and there's bad things. You can always find hope. And then I spelled hope out in pebbles.
Mine is about the landscape of Afghanistan because they have a really unique landscape. They have deserts and mountains in Afghanistan. And I made it because, like this mosaic, the people are equally unique. They're pretty much the same as us. They just don't have as many advantages as we do.
The flag is just that, it's a sign of courage. Like when they fly it outside their homes, that's what it's like supposed to mean. They have a lot of courage.
The project is actually called the U.S.-Afghan Junior Investor Program. The program initially was to help our students learn to be global citizens and how they can help someone else in the world. And so we wanted to really focus on the history and the rich culture of Afghanistan and teach these kids that it's not all negative and it's not all scary and it's not all confusing. The people are normal, but the life and situation around them is chaotic. So we put together this program to really introduce our kids to Afghanistan and get them to understand and appreciate it. I worked with Dina Fessler through Children's Culture Connection. It's a nonprofit based out of Denison, Minnesota. And we wanted to pick something relevant, something that's in the news that our kids could really relate to, and we chose Afghanistan. And we created a 10-part program that teaches all about Afghanistan, the culture, the history, the art, everything you can imagine, the food, the clothing, and the mosaics were created out of our art and recreation unit.
Our country, United States, has been intertwined for nearly a decade with Afghanistan, yet it's fascinating how little people know of Afghanistan. And a lot of people, and I'm at times, I'm sure I've been guilty of it myself, is like we have a tendency to think that's other people's problems to solve. And it's, if it was something that was easy to solve, it would have been solved a long time ago.
The Afghanistan project is to like get the message out to people saying that they can't just look at them for like what they look like and what they don't have. You like can't take them for granted. You have to like be nice and treat them as you treat others.
I think it's just a way for like kids here to connect with kids over there and to kind of pretty much get to know them better, to understand what they're going through.
In my opinion, I think it was mostly about learning about the outside world, like other than Cannon Falls or the United States, like learning other perspectives, because they're a third world country and we're like a first world country. And it's just like different, so we learned like the different perspectives.
We really thought about what's an important piece of art in Afghanistan, and the mosaics are obviously an ancient art form that comes from the country. So I went around and got a lot of different little shops to donate tile pieces for us. We got quite a variety, and the kids all created their own mosaic. We asked them to pick one piece of the program that really meant something to them, or something they really learned from the 10-week program, and create a mosaic around it. And this is what they came up with.
Mosaics, tiling is a very popular art form in Afghanistan. Great buildings and mosques, and the tiling on it is all very representative. It tells a story within what it is. And then of course, the other reason for mosaics on a teaching level is that you can't just whip them together. But that's where the passion comes from. I mean, if it was something that they could just like craft it together in an hour or two, they're not having the same experience.
They had a tough time starting. They didn't. They're given all this tile and they're given a board and told create something. Well, that's kind of tough for anybody. So then we had them really focus on one part of the program that really inspired them, and that was pretty easy. They all found their topic pretty quickly, and then it just fell into place for them. They'd take a few pieces of tile and they'd imagine what they wanted this to be, and it just came together. It was really fun to watch them. The overwhelming theme that I think is shown is hope. Children are resilient. They can make it through a lot, and they are optimistic by nature. So they usually found something that was powerful and hopeful in which to create their mosaic. They really like teaching, and that's when true learning has taken place, when you can turn around and teach what you've learned. And these kids can do that. You can sit down with them and have a conversation about Afghanistan, and they can teach you a lot.